to be a Nintendo fan waking up on a normal Tuesday. Psych. This was not a normal Tuesday, because there was a Nintendo Direct. Well, seeing as these announcements are right around the corner, is there a better time than now to talk about Splatfests? I don't believe for a moment that we're done with them. Like, nope. Not at all. Nintendo said that we only had a certain number of Splatfests left between now and March 31st, and we've used all of them up. But you know what? Nintendo never said we couldn't get any more after that date. Nintendo needs this Direct to share what's coming up in the first half of the year, because March 31st is the end of the fiscal year. That means Nintendo has to start putting out games, content, DLC, anything to push profits for the new business year until they put out more games. I asked my community what they believed would be in the Nintendo Direct, and at one point I noticed a lot of people talking about Splatoon 3. Do I think we'll get Splatoon 3 eventually? Totally. But honestly, I don't see us getting it right now. So let's go to a realm of slightly more possibility and talk about Splatfests. What could be better? When Nintendo puts out a new fighter for Smash, people not only buy that DLC for the fighter, but fans of that character sometimes are pushed to buy Smash. The same thing happens with Splatfest. We know Splatoon 2 is one of Nintendo's best-selling games on the Switch. People craved the ability to play with each other, and Splatoon 2 filled that void. Nintendo has given Splatoon 2 so many updates, so many weapons, and even gave us DLC. I never would have imagined that in the first game. Whenever Nintendo throws out a new Splatfest, it not only brings back the dormant, update-hungry audience that still exists in the Splatoon 2 community, but it also gets new players to purchase the game. Think about all the people who probably caved and bought Splatoon when the Mario Splatfest got announced. Imagine if that was the last one, and now people had no more Splatfests to look forward to? If Nintendo wants to convert even more of its user base into Splatoon havers, all they gotta do is put out new Splatfests or just add new features. Splatoon 2 is approaching 4 years old, so they'll probably just go with Splatfests while they continue to develop Splatoon 3. Now, what Splatfest would Nintendo do, though? While I know that we as a community would prefer a new Splatfest, like a Legend of Zelda Anniversary Splatfest, I don't think we'll see that. I'm totally okay with being clowned on if Nintendo drops something like this in the Direct, though. Nintendo made it clear that we shouldn't get any more Splatfests prior to the end of March. If Nintendo is gonna pick up a Splatfest to rerun, they'll wanna pick something that was worldwide, important to the community, and probably close in results, so doing a rerun makes sense. I believe that we're gonna get Springfest 2.0, and here's why. Here are the results from the first Springfest. Just like the Trick vs. Treat Splatfest, the Hare vs. Tortoise Splatfest had the less popular team win by a very small margin. About 43% of the vote was able to win one of the types of battles by about 1%. Interestingly, the close call in this Splatfest was in the pro battles, where in the Trick vs. Treat Splatfest it was in the normal battles. Wouldn't it be interesting to give Team Tortoise another chance at victory? This was also one of the special Splatfests, and I'm sure people would be happy to have a chance at receiving that special Springfest gear again without having to scroll through multiple pages of news on the Nintendo Switch. This Splatfest hits all the right marks. It was an all-region Splatfest. It was a 48-hour Splatfest. It had very close results, and it was a significant event. The first Splatfest was on the weekend of April 19th through the 21st, so we're chronologically still on pace with where the first Trick vs. Treat Splatfest was, which happened before the Springfest, obviously, and it would make sense to celebrate its anniversary in April, which is again after March, making it a great candidate for a rerun Splatfest. Come on! Easter Sunday is on April 4th this year, but I don't see Splatfest being so soon after March 31st, even if that would be funny. So I think if we're getting this rerun Splatfest, it could be on the weekend of April 16th through April 18th. That would make it almost exactly 2 years after the original Springfest. Do you guys agree with me? Do you think that we have a decent chance of seeing a rerun Splatfest for Springfest? Or do you think that we'll see something else? Or maybe even nothing else? I think Springfest 2.0 would be a significant enough event that would bring more people back to the game, as well as drive up some extra sales for good old Nintendo. Also, the colors are really nice. Please, just let me use the heavy splatling remix with the Springfest colors, Nintendo. Please. It just looks so pretty. And don't think that if we don't see the announcement in the Direct tomorrow that Springfest still can't happen. If Springfest 2.0 was to happen in mid-April, they could announce it as late as mid-March, and we'd still have over a month before the Splatfest. I could see them holding it as a funny little surprise, given there's Pokemon and Zelda anniversaries to focus on right now for Nintendo. Just, you know, wait for the hype to die down a little bit and bang. Splatfest. As a side note, I think that putting this Splatfest in now would also open Nintendo to the idea of doing friends versus family at the end of this year. If Nintendo spreads out all the special Splatfests, so to speak, it'll give longevity to Splatoon 2 while not requiring the development team to be constantly creating new material for the game. One holiday fest in October of 2020, one holiday fest in April of 2021, you know, even May if we gotta, and then one in December of 2021. That's decently spread apart without making the player base get too tired of holiday Splatfests. I'm excited for the possibility of more Splatfests in the game, and I hope you are too! Thank you for listening to my thoughts, and I hope we see something Splatoon-related in the Direct, even if it isn't related to the fests. See ya!